deserve to be there.
You would have invited all of us.
If you can't figure it out, you don't deserve it.
If you compare where we are today in the Middle East to where we were 9 months ago, and you ask which is better, I think it is impossible for anyone to compare the two and come to any conclusion other than that the Biden foreign policy has been an absolute disaster. 9 months ago, the Abraham Accords, historic peace agreements, were being signed, and Israel and Arab nations were arm in arm coming together for peace. 9 months later, we once again have war in the Middle East. By any measure, even the most rabid Democratic partisan would be hard pressed to say, well, the first few months of Biden's Middle East policy have been a success. Sadly, they've been a disaster. And when one realizes that, the answer is not to double down on the mistakes Joe Biden and Kamala Harris made in the first 4 months. It's rather to look to what works. And what works is strength and its clarity. It's not the deliberate ambiguity and weakness that was the hallmark of Barack Obama's foreign policy and now seems to be the hallmark of Joe Biden's. In 4 years, I threw the tickets away every night, and I said, all right, if I can't talk my... Israel is our strongest ally in the Middle East. Israel shares our values. It is a free democracy that protects human rights. The enemies of Israel are the enemies of America, and there are enormous military benefits to the United States from our alliance, whether it is the Mossad sharing intelligence about Iran and the Ayatollah seeking to murder Americans and murder Israelis, or whether it is the incredible technological leaps and bounds that we get from missile defense that helps keep Americans safe. And so I hope that Joe Biden and Kamala Harris have the strength of character to tell the angry anti-Israel left in their party to tell them no, to tell them we're going to maintain our historic alliance and we're going to replenish Iron Dome and not dither around, but do it immediately, because we don't know when the next rock attacks are going to come. What did Joe Biden do when he came back in? Ignored that law and sent hundreds of millions of dollars to the Palestinian Authority, and that emboldened Hamas. That was a big part of the reason these rockets started coming, is weakness invites attacks, and the more Joe Biden shows weakness to Hamas or Hezbollah or Iran, the more you're going to see terrorist attacks escalating. That's the wrong path. I believe in peace through strength, and appeasing terrorists doesn't produce peace.
So it was made on this Memorial Day weekend, and we certainly send our hearts out to those families. We're very concerned about any monies that go to the Gaza Strip that are, quote, intended for infrastructure. Mm-hmm. Can be easily diverted by Hamas. We spent time today talking with military officers who have seen many types of pipes, all types of construction equipment, so to speak, converted to military use, converted into weaponry and componentry for missiles that are and projectiles that are being sent here. We need to avoid that at all cost. Iron Dome has done a fantastic job of protecting civilian life. Mm-hmm. I think it also does a great job of deterring this type of activity. And I think our monies are far better spent supporting our ally, mm-hmm, and replenishing the Iron Dome.